Dinosaurs ruled the Earth for millions of years until an asteroid killed them off. In their place, there arose a very different creature, mammals. Mammals now rule the Earth. They're so ubiquitous, so common, that we forget how revolutionary they once were. They were so different from what came before. Mammals move differently. A dog and a lizard have a very different way of running around. Mammals eat differently. They've developed a very unique ability. Mammals can chew their food. Chewing might seem like a piece of cake, but it's not. It's actually complicated. Mammals have big brains. They have excellent hearing and a keen sense of smell. Mammals have a unique way of caring for their kids. They feed them milk. Mammals have hair. Hair keeps their bodies warm, and they're warm-blooded, giving them their powerful speed, strength, and stamina. All these special abilities gave mammals the power to rule the world. These abilities were revolutionary in their time. But since they changed everything, they now seem ordinary, commonplace. In this video, I'm going to tell you about all the things we take for granted, the abilities that led mammals to take over the world. Mammals move differently from reptiles. Reptiles wiggle their bodies from side to side, while mammals move up and down. This helps mammals breathe. You see, when a reptile is wiggling side to side, one of its lungs is expanded while the other is compressed, and then this switches between the lungs. Air moves between the lungs, and this interferes with breathing. Reptiles have trouble running and breathing at the same time. Mammals don't have this problem because their bodies are designed to move up and down. Their legs stand upright. Their vertebrae have brakes to stop them from wiggling side to side. Mammals can chew food. You might think that this is easy, that all you need are some teeth, but it's more complicated than that. Reptiles can't do it very well. They can bite and they can swallow, but to chew properly, the teeth have to fit together tightly. You need special jaw muscles to move the jaw, not just up and down, but also in and out, left and right. And you need a single jawbone. Reptiles have many jawbones, but mammals have just one. With the right jawbone, the right muscles, the right teeth, you can chew your food like a mammal. And chewing is important. It helps us digest our food and extract more nutrients. Mammals have different teeth for different purposes. They have incisors for cutting, canines for stabbing, and molars for grinding. Reptile teeth all look the same. They don't fit together, and they don't have permanent teeth. Their teeth will fall out and get replaced throughout their lives. This is a big problem if you need the teeth to always fit together. Mammal teeth fit together, but they don't have an unlimited supply of teeth. Mammals have baby teeth and adult teeth, and that's it. Reptiles have jaws that are made of several different bones, while mammal jaws are just one solid bone. The jaw muscles all attach to this one bone, and this allows mammals to precisely control how their teeth bite down. Mammals and reptiles have a common ancestor. As mammals evolved, their front jawbone got bigger and bigger, while their other jawbones withered away. But they didn't disappear. These bones are still in our bodies, but they're not in your jaw anymore. You'll never guess where they are now. They're in your ear. They help us hear sounds. These bones are tiny. They're about the size of a grain of rice, but they're essential for hearing. They're called the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup, because they look like these objects. When you hear sound, the sound waves hit your eardrum. The eardrum is connected to these former jawbones, and they transmit the sound into your inner ear. These bones act as little levers that amplify the sound. Mammals have some of the best ears in the animal kingdom, and they're especially good at picking up high-pitched sounds. Now you can tell that these ear bones had once been jawbones, not just by looking at the fossil record, but also by looking at embryos. As an embryo develops, these bones start out as jawbones. They originate in the jaw, and then they move to the ear. Something even weirder happens in marsupials. Marsupials are born prematurely before their jawbones have become ear bones. So when they're born, they use these bones as jawbones just for the first few weeks, and then the jawbones turn into ear bones. Reptiles have scales, birds have feathers, and mammals have hair. Hair is so useful. Eyebrow hair keeps sweat out of our eyes. Eyelashes detect dangerous objects approaching our eyes. Whisker hairs help the cat and mouse navigate in the dark. Body hair insulates our bodies, keeping us warm. And that's important because we're warm-blooded. Mammals produce their own heat, while reptiles depend on their surroundings to do it for them. Mammals have a built-in heater. Their body temperature, it's not just warmer, it's also more controlled and more stable. High, stable body temperatures give mammals their astounding athletic abilities. They can run faster, they can run longer. The trade-off is that mammals have to eat more calories. Even when they're resting, they have to burn more calories just to stay warm. Where did the word mammal come from? It came from mammary glands. Mammary glands produce milk. Milk is a very nutritious, reliable source of energy, giving the mammal kids a great start in life. Reptile kids have deadbeat parents that don't look after them. Bird babies have involved parents, but they don't have any milk to give them. They can't just build up a supply of milk when it's easy for them. They have to find some worms when the babies are hungry. When mammals first develop milk, they also develop big brains. This is probably no coincidence. Big brains are very useful, but they're also very expensive. Brains consume lots of calories. To show you how smart we are, let's plot brain size versus body size. Here we see fish, then reptiles and amphibians, then birds. They all have small brains compared to mammals. The dinosaurs were very big, but they weren't very bright. For instance, Diplodocus was huge. It weighed 30 tons, but its brain was as light as a tennis ball. Compare that to an elephant. Elephants are smaller, but their brains are 50 times bigger. And the real brain champions are humans. Pound for pound, we have some of the biggest brains in the animal kingdom. We've now seen mammals' special abilities. With their exceptional brains, ears, milk, teeth, and hair, mammals took over the world, diversifying into a stunning array of different creatures. Some mammals grew out their finger bones, creating a wing and becoming flying bats. Others dove into the sea, swapping arms and legs for flippers, becoming whales and dolphins. There are big mammals, elephants, rhinos, and hippos, small mammals, chipmunks, mice, and weasels, violent mammals, lions, tigers, and bears, timid mammals, rabbits, pandas, and mice, slow mammals, fast mammals. There are mammals that bounce, mammals that glide, mammals that climb, mammals that dam, mammals that stink, mammals that dig, mammals that fly, mammals that swim, and we are mammals. Humans and their mammal friends have come to dominate the land. We can measure the dominance of different categories of animals by weighing them. This chart shows you the weight of all land vertebrates. Humans take about a third of the weight. Our livestock and our pets take more than 60% of it. Our livestock is mostly made of mammals and a few chickens. On the other hand, wild mammals and wild birds represent just a small fraction compared to humans and their livestock. Mammals are the clear winner here, with birds in second place, and reptiles and amphibians are too small to even notice. Here I'm just talking about land vertebrates. You could argue that insects really rule the world, or even bacteria. But if we're talking about large land animals, then we are living in the age of mammals. In my next video, I'll talk about the history of mammals, their relatives, and the mammal family tree. For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe. Yes, I know, this video had nothing to do with astronomy, but I don't want to change the name of my channel.